Hey guys, welcome to this new video. Long time I haven't done any video, so welcome back, and welcome back to me too. And to make it a bit more interesting than just designing a random shape, I decided to create a sort of real concept and bring it from sketch to 3D and maybe do a prototype of it. So last time I was in a conference call in a client office, and I was looking at this device that we had in the middle of the table. And I was wondering why this thing has to be like a black plastic and something that you are not really proud to put in the middle of the table. That I remembered Google actually has one, so I thought I should take this opportunity to create a concept and redesign this conference call device. So what I used to sketch, so black pen for construction, set of C2, C4 and black marker to shade. I also used this pink marker, sort of peach marker, to create the copper effect, which I'm going to use here, and black and white pencils to emphasize the contrast and add gradients to your shape, so strong black, strong white. I use this bright color pencil, also orange. This is very interesting to create LEDs or to emphasize different areas of the product, or just simply if you want to bring life to your sketch, then use highlighters or use things that are very eye-catching. And to finish, white pen for all the highlights and correct all the mistakes. So let's look at this little design that I've been working on. I let you have a look at how I sketch it. I think you can understand by yourself. If you don't, then just leave some comments somewhere on the blog or below the video. And the thing I want to do is actually more talking about the design and why this design is the way it is. But first, why drawing 2D views? So at first it's easy and quick to draw. So it doesn't really require any sort of perspective skills. So if you struggle with perspectives, then this will allow you to explore the design easily. And it's also much more accurate than a perspective drawing, so you can print the placement or the components and sketch on top of this. So you become one step closer to the reality. And then you can use these 2D views, you scan it and you put it in your 3D software like Rhino, and this will help you to build the 3D on something that is very close to the reality. And okay, so now let me explain a bit why this concept has this sort of shape. So at first, this device is for professional use. Most of these conference call devices are usually made of black plastic, and I don't see why the professional world should look that impersonal. So I decided to take another approach to it and make it something that is very easy to use, very simple, and a product that you can be proud to put in the middle of your meeting room in front of your clients. For Google, it's also a way to promote Google Hangout, even facilitate its use. So the main shape of this thing is this sort of donut. It fits the Google DNA, even if I made it a bit more dynamic than what they have. It's the simplicity of the circle, which I'm trying to emphasize within the DNA of this product. And at this stage, I use this copper or brass, I don't really know yet, to take it away from the expected black plastic. In fact, all these devices, we assume that they should be black. There's no real reason for that. It's just that we are used to it. So that's why I thought there was a great opportunity here. And so if you look at the base of this product, there's this sort of rubber base, this grip, typical from Google with this minimal G logo at the base. I use it to improve the grip, of course, but also the perception of quality, as when you place it on the table, it doesn't have this sort of cheap plastic sound, but rather it has this very soft sound when it gets in contact with the table. And I think this unconsciously explains that this product has a lot more quality to it. Also, I put this screen on top. It's actually very not Google, because I think Google wants to use the phone as the interface. But for now, it's just a concept, so I'm trying to facilitate the use of this product. And as you see the details, like the on-off button or the LED around the rubber at the base or the speaker holes, all this is fully integrated. And the reason why I try to integrate all these things is that I try to keep the simplicity of the product. And I don't want to stick something on top. I want everything to have a seamless integration of all the different components. And why? Because if you keep the simplicity of the product, then therefore your product appears more easy to use, and people are more likely to want to use it. In fact, we are all a bit lazy, so as soon as something feels a bit complicated, we are like, oh yeah, okay, I'm not going to bother too much with this product. So keeping the simplicity in every product I design, it's a key to create something that is more approachable and that people will have a better desire to use and try. And you have this general shape, this sort of donut. It's actually not really a donut, it's like a sort of section of a circle and a curve. But I think that you always have to treat the surfaces in a more interesting way. And this is used to make it a bit more compact, a bit more modern. I use this part line in the middle of the curve, so that's also create like modernity. And I think that's all for now. So I hope you enjoyed this little video. If you want to see the next one, just subscribe to the channel on YouTube, because I will bring this into 3D and render it and try to bring a bit more explanations on the making of a product. So thank you guys, see you next time. I hope you enjoy seeing a bit of my beard in this video, and I will talk to you soon. Cheers guys, bye.